On the line. Let's now get updates on the ASEAN Women's Business Conference happening at the PICC. Our correspondent Michelle Long joins us on the line from there. So what's the latest, Mimi?
Hi, Kathy. Well, we are now down to the last, second to the last panel discussions. They're about to wrap up. That panel is about how ASEAN can accelerate change to achieve workplace gender equality. You've got the audience hearing from Myanmar Tourism Marketing Officer, Regional Director of Thailand and Vietnam of ADECO, and Project Leader of the Mekong Business Initiative. They will be going for a very quick break, and then to the last panel. The title of that panel is No More Excuses, The Way Forward. We will be hearing from the Chairman of Philippine Women's Economic Network, Ms. Butch Giatina Garcia, as well as the Deputy CEO of Malaysia External Trade Development Corp, and Ms. Gabrielle Castigan, former Chief Executive Officer of Lynn Fox International Group. That will be followed by a presentation to sum up the co-chair statement before closing remarks at 5:30. Kathy, it just came to a very interesting conversation with Indonesia Business Coalition for Women Empowerment Group, Executive Director Dini Widiastuti, who actually said that education is actually key to bridging gender pay gap, at least in their context in Indonesia. We do know that the women empowerment still needs a lot of work done when it comes when in Indonesia. She did say that they're trying to push for to have girls stay in school for longer, from 9 years to 12 years, so they won't be forced to get into any early marriage in their young age. She did say that when you have education, the gender pay gap becomes narrower. For example, for those who graduate from high school, you've got 50% gender pay gap between men and women who work in low-skill jobs. But for those who, as you move upwards, the work ladder there, for example, it becomes smaller. For example, 21% for those who finish high school, and 6.2% for those in higher positions, like in banking, just 6.2%. So the gender pay gap is reduced as you go up. You have higher education, better education, less gender pay gap. She did give us a context for Indonesia, where only about 20% of their top middle managers are women. If you go higher than that, top management, only 5 to 6% are actually women. Lots of work needs to be done when it comes to women empowerment, women participation in the labor force, especially in Indonesia. Again, a stark contrast to the Philippines. Actually, the Philippines ranks among the highest when it comes to the gender gap report of WEF. We are number 7 out of 144 countries versus Indonesia's 85th ranking. Kathy?
Okay, thank you so much for that update on the gender pay gap story there at the ASEAN Women's Summit. Going back to the Senate hearing and to the Shabu